Really good to be with you again. It's Kinookie's time. So, starting this weekend and for the next few weeks, everybody at Christ the Rock is looking at a bit of the Bible, which is in a book called Luke. So this is in the New Testament, quite near the end of the Bible. If you've got a Bible, you could look it up. So Luke chapter 4. And if you look for the small numbers, in verse 16, it says what happens. I'm going to read it to you. Are you ready? Jesus travelled to Nazareth, where he had grown up. On the Sabbath day, he went to the synagogue, as he always did, and Jesus stood up to read. The book of Isaiah the prophet was given to him. He opened the book and found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord is in me. This is because God chose me to tell the good news to the poor. God sent me to tell the prisoners of sin that they are free, and to tell the blind that they can see again. God sent me to free those who have been treated unfairly, and to announce the time when the Lord will show kindness to his people." Jesus closed the book, gave it back, and sat down. Everyone in the synagogue was watching Jesus closely. He began to speak to them and he said, "While you heard these words just now, they were coming true." Wow. So Jesus was saying that as he read out those words that had been written hundreds of years before, they were coming true. Those words were about him and about what he was doing. So I've been thinking that these words were about what Jesus had come to do. And I think he'd come to bring all of God's good stuff to earth. We sometimes call all of God's good stuff his kingdom. So our group is called Kingdom Kids, isn't it? And that's because we're part of God's kingdom. We're part of all the good stuff that Jesus brought. So I've been thinking that these verses, all of these good things that Jesus came to do, are like something that Jesus said in the book of John. So if you've got a Bible, if you look in the book of John, which is just after Luke, in chapter 10 and verse 10, Jesus is talking about sheep and gates and lots of really interesting things. And then he says, "I came to give life, life in all its fullness." I think that's kind of what we're talking about here in these verses in Luke 4. I think we're talking about all of the good stuff that Jesus came to bring. It was life in all its fullness. So there's some makaton signs for this. So we could say, Jesus said, "I have come to give life." This is life. You make your tall finger go forwards a bit and then you move it in a circle. Life in all its fullness. So this is all. Make a big circle with our hand. So Jesus said, "I've come to bring life. Life in all its fullness." So there was somebody that Jesus met who didn't have life in all its fullness. He wasn't enjoying all of those good things that God had for him. And his name was Zacchaeus. You've probably heard his story before. You may have even heard me tell it before, but this is a good story. So I sometimes call him Zac because that's a bit easier to say. So this man called Zac, the Bible says that he was a tax collector, which is an okay job. It's a good job. That's somebody who collects up little bits of money from people so that the money can be used for things like building roads and schools. But Zac took too much money from people and then he kept all that money for himself. So he had lots of stuff, but he didn't have God's good stuff. So this is what happened to Zac. Jesus came to the place where Zach lived. The town was called Jericho. And here's Jesus. It's Jesus. And he's got his 12 friends with him. And everywhere he went, people wanted to be with him, didn't they? So lots of people are crowding around Jesus and they want to see him and they want to hear what he's got to say. I wonder if you can see Zach. Can you see Zach? He's hiding, isn't he? You see him? Yes, he's up in the tree. And Jesus knew he was up in the tree because Jesus knows everything, doesn't he? So Jesus said, Zach, come on down. Today I'm coming to your house. So Zach climbed down very carefully. And Jesus came to his house. And they had a meal together. And all the people said, Zach is a bad man. Why is Jesus going to his house? I don't know what happened. The Bible doesn't tell us what happened while Jesus and Zach were together eating. But after the meal, Zach said, I am going to give half my money away to poor people. And if I've taken money from someone, I'm going to pay them back 4 times as much. Wow. So Zach met Jesus and he changed completely. He got all of that good stuff in his life, all of that joy and peace and love, and it changed him. Have you got one of these? We gave lots away over the summer. If you haven't got one and you'd like one, let me know and I'll get you one. So it's a Bible question cube. And I coloured mine in, look. And what you can do with it, after you've heard a Bible story, you can roll it and it will give you a question. So I'm going to roll mine now. Ooh, it has landed with this question showing. So this question says, I wonder which part of this story is most important? That's a good question. Which part of this story is most important? I might have to think about that. What do you think? Which part of this story, Zach meeting Jesus, do you think is most important? I'd love to know what you think. Maybe if you've got one of these, you could give it a roll and see what question it asks you. And you could think about this story a bit more when Jesus met Zach. It's nearly time for me to go, but before I go, shall we pray together? Okay, let's pray. Thank you, Jesus, that you came. We are so glad you came, and we are so glad that you brought all of God's good stuff. Thank you that we can enjoy being your friend. Thank you that you help us with all of the hard stuff, and you're always with us. Thank you for your love and your joy and your peace. Help us to keep on staying close to you and enjoying those things for our whole lives, all day, every day. Amen. It has been great to be with you. Take care and I will see you again very soon. Bye-bye.